Students, now let us see how we can plot zeros and ones into the K-map. Okay, so they might give you the mean term expansion of a function, or sometimes they may give you max term expansion of a function. So suppose if they give the mean term expansion of a function, how you can plot the mean term expansion? So it can be plotted on a map by placing ones in the square, which correspond to mean terms of the function, and zeros in the remaining squares. So what does that means here is, for example, if you are considering f of a comma b comma c, so there are three variables we considered here. So if you are considering the function with three variables, this is how the a map looks like. So a, one side you will be taking one variable, that is a. We have considered here a. You can consider b also, c also, anything it might be. But if I consider here a at the top side, the left side you have to consider b, c. Is it? So a can be, again, there are two forms for a, variable a. It can be either 0 or 1. So that's what we have written here, 0 and 1. And b also, b, c also can take different forms, that is, possibility of values for BC is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. So here f of a comma b comma c, this is example we are going to take. So that is equal to summation of mean terms 1 comma 3 comma 5. So how you can plot these mean terms now with the K-map? So 1 is a term you have here. So where to plot that? That is what your they're asking you. Okay, in the exams they may ask you how to plot this particular function. So how you can do that? So here, one can be based, so it is a mean term. Okay, so before that, you have to write the positions here. So already it is being written here, positions of these mean term positions is being already written. So you can see that 0 is written here. 1, this you have, 3, this is 2, then 3 here, and 4, fourth position, mean term position is here, 5th you have, 6th and 7th mean term positions. So mean term positions you have to write first, and then you can easily plot the values into the graph. So first mean term, so whatever the value, mean term means, it's where you have to place once, is it? So you can place this term in the first mean term position. The second value is mean term 3 you have, is it? So that 3 mean term means 1 you have to place in the third position, and 5th you have to write where 5th mean term position you can place it in this position. So this is how you have to first fill the mean terms to the particular K-map. Then rest of the values, what you have to write, all the values, whatever is left out, you have to fill with zeros. Okay. So what are the max term positions now? So seeing this K-map itself, you can write the max term positions also. So that is product of max terms 0, 2, 4, 7. So whatever is left out will be the max term positions in this particular graph.
So now let us solve the K-map for the product terms. So let us take one, there are three examples we are going to take here. First example is this, second one, third problem, okay. So if you see this particular problem, and if you write the K-map in this manner, so they have already plotted once in this particular K-map, and where the zeros are. Zeros are all, you have to understand that zeros are being placed in this manner. Okay, so whatever the left out space will be filled by zeros. Okay, and now if you want to solve this particular problem, how the expression will be. So here, something you, if you are seeing here, A bar and A gets cancelled, and here what remains is here. You remain with the expression in this manner. So what you can see here is B, okay, B, that is
you have the following expression now. So that is BC plus BC bar. What is the answer? So when you encircle this four ones here, you are going to form a quad. Okay, what is that? You are going to see a largest group in the K map, and you are encircling the K map and you are forming the quad. So that means quad means it has four ones, so you have grouped it together and you have formed a quad. So whenever you write the expression for the quad, it is in this manner. Now for this particular problem, you have in this manner. So the BC plus BC bar is equal to B. You get the final answer is B. So one thing you have to remember whenever you solve a K map is you have to group or you have to encircle the largest group in the K map. So if you are finding, suppose the complete all the eight squares are being filled with ones, think that if that is the case, you are going to form a octet there. Okay, and you are going to later solve the problem. Okay, you are going to group the octets. But here there are only four ones, so it is not an octet now, it's a quad. Suppose there was a pair, as the second problem, you are going to see a pair here, is it? So, in that case, it is a different answer you will be getting. But the thing is, you can see pairs in the first problem also, but we have grouped the largest grouping possible in this K map. So that's why we have encircled this quad. Okay, we have encircled the quad here. So that is what we get B as a final answer. And if you are seeing the second problem, how you can write the expression? So here, again in this particular thing, if you are seeing, I have encircled a pair, seeing that it is all ones. Okay. And see here, rest of the values, whatever is left out, will be all zeros. Okay, you have to consider it as zeros, rest of the squares. And how are you going to get the BC, BB, BC bar as a expression? That is here, A with A, A bar and A gets cancelled, and finally you remain only with this, is it? So what is this? What is the meaning of this? That is B, C bar. So this is a final expression. This is the final expression. So this is the final expression. Similarly, okay, let me erase this. So next problem. If you are seeing this particular thing, you are seeing all ones at this corner and one another at another corner. And you are going to fill all the other squares as zeros. Okay, we have done this way. So all zeros. And I want to group now. So if you are grouping in this manner, it will lead to two different expressions. So what we are going to do? We want to form a group in such a manner that which is the largest group possible in the K-map. You are going to see logically. Not physically, if you are seeing one is at the other end, this one is at the other end. Okay, so physically, if you are seeing that, it's totally different parts, is it? But logically, if you are seeing, they are very near, they are adjacent. Okay, this one and this one is very adjacent to each other. Okay, why? Because you can, the variable here. B changes from 0 to 1. Okay, so only one variable is going to change from that is 0 to 1. So that is why it is called adjacent group. Or adjacent ones, you can see here in this particular problem. So that is why if the ones are adjacent, you can group them. So that is the rule in K-map. So what we do, we corners we are going to group in this manner, okay, and we form the expression as what you can write the expression here as it is finally C is again 0
Okay, so I'll be writing the expression now. B, it is B bar, C bar, okay, B bar, C bar plus, and you have B, C, one side, okay. So what remains here? C bar you have. So this B bar plus B gets cancelled and you remain with C bar. Okay, C bar. Other side you have one more thing, that is here A is equal to 1. That also you have to write. Okay, so final expression will be A C bar.
So now let us see the simplification of three variable function. So here our rule here is, so when you solve any particular problem, we have to remember this particular rule. So what is the rule here? Terms in the adjacent squares on the map differ in only one variable and you can combine them. So what it means is, whenever you are trying to do the pairs, okay, or quads, or you say octets, when you are going to plot it in the particular k-map, okay, so you have to consider the adjacent squares in the map, okay, which differs only by one variable. So here, what is one variable and how you can combine them? If you consider here, A is one variable, okay, it differs in only one position. So here, A changes from 0 to 1. So that means you can combine this 1, 1, 1, okay, and you can make it as one single pair. Okay, so this is adjacency. Why? Because A changes from A bar to A. Okay, so it is a adjacent square. So terms in adjacent square on the map differ by only one variable. Okay, and you can combine them. Okay, so this is what you can understand from this. Okay, so this is one particular example we have taken. So for example, A bar B bar C and A bar B C combined to form A bar C, and also A bar B bar C and A B bar C combined to form B bar C. Okay, so here there are two pairs you can see here. So one pair is this one, okay, another pair is this one. Okay, so you have now plotted the mean terms and you have combined the ones in the k-map. Okay, so now you have to write the expression for this particular function. So how you can write here is, so what is this one, what is this one? So it is this is one. So it is A bar B, so let us see that it is A bar B bar and C. Okay, A bar B bar C, you write that same thing. Okay, plus what you are going to add here is one more term, that is, what is the value of one here? How you can write an expression, that is, it is A bar and BC. So that's what we have written, A bar BC here. So which term is getting cancelled here? If you are doing that, which term is getting cancelled? So A bar B bar C plus A bar BC, when you are going to combine that, one term gets cancelled. So that is, B term gets cancelled by, because B bar plus B is equal to 0. That's why A final expression is A bar C. Okay. Similarly, the other term you can find here is, so the other term here is
what you have tried, you have already combined this and you have found the expression here. The next thing is you are going to combine 1 1, or you have paired 1 1 and you are writing the expression. So how you can write the expression? What is the term here? That is 1. How you can write 1? 1 is A bar. Let's see that. It is A bar, B bar, C bar. Okay. A bar, B bar, and C bar. So plus, and also one more expression you have, that is A, B bar, C bar. So finally, what is remaining? What will remain if you are writing that? So there, A gets cancelled. Okay, why? Because A bar plus A getting cancelled, and finally you remain with B bar C. B bar C. So A is actually getting cancelled here. Why? Okay. So here also, by saying this thing also, you can write. Why? Because A has been changed from 0 to 1. Is it similarly here? Which is going to be, which variable is going to change? It is B variable. So 0 to 1. So that term will get in cancelled. Okay, remaining you have tried. What is remaining? Okay, that you are going to write. So simplified form of K map you have got. So final expression will be F is equal to A bar C. So that is from this A bar C and B bar C, which is the final expression. So now let us see the K maps that illustrates the consensus theorem. So this particular theorem is already being explained in previous slides. So here you have going to consider one particular algebraic expression, that is xy is equal plus bar z plus yz. Okay, this is the expression. And what do you get from that expression is that is equal to xy plus x bar z. Why? Because you have cancelled one term here, that is yz is being cancelled. Why? Because this yz is a consensus term. Okay, so x and x changes to, so one variable is being changed from x to x bar. It's being changed from x to x bar. So which is the left out term? So yz is a left out term. So that yz is considered as a consensus term. So you get expression as xy plus bar z. So this is one of the examples we have taken. And now, if you have plotted this particular expression to the K-map, how it looks is, so note that here the consensus term yz is redundant because its ones are being covered by other two terms. So, if you have the K-map now illustrates the consensus theorem that is being applied here. So, let us see a particular problem here. So, you have a K-map. Okay, with variables x, y, z, and here already you have plotted this particular expression to the K map. Okay, so what is x, y? X, y, z is not shown here, but z is actually 0, that is considered 0 here in that case. So, what is x, y? So, x, y is x and y you have. Okay. XY is, so X is 1 here, so that particular case means X and Y. Y is also not means, so Y, there you have 1 1, there we are going to write this particular thing. Okay, so X is 1 and Y is also 1. Okay, so we are seeing this particular thing. This is y variable, right? So this thing and this. Okay. So
x, y, you are plotting now. So where x, y lies, that is 1, 1 here. Similarly, x bar z, x bar z, x bar means it is 0. Okay? 0 and z, z is 1, 1 itself. So x bar z means 0, 1. X value is 0 and z value is 1, 1. Which is that? This particular. So you have written 1, 1 over here. And next thing, the one more expression, that is y, z. You have y is 1, z is 1. So when you have y is 1, z is 1, so y is 1 and also z is 1. Where you have y z expression, okay? So that is y is 1, z is 1 you have here. So that's why you are going to write 1, 1 over in this particular thing. So now when you are, next thing is, whenever you write this particular ones into the K-map, and later you have to plot that or encircle the ones. So how we can encircle? Adjacent ones are being encircled. So you are going to encircle in this manner, encircle in this manner, because you are finding everywhere adjacent ones. So, but you have plotted or you have encircled twice. This particular one and this particular one is being encircled twice. So that is a consistent term, so, or a redundant term that is not needed. So our simplified K-map is now in this manner. So you have to remove that YZ term or consensus term, and you have to make it look in a simplified manner. So our K-map now is this. Why? Because we have removed that YZ term. So what is the final expression? You get XY plus X bar Z. So there are possibilities of getting two minimum solutions when you are trying to solve any Boolean expression. So you try to solve the problem and you finally end up with different types of expressions. So each one of you may get different answers. So when you are trying, which one is right, you may think. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to plot those expressions onto the K-map, and you can see that where these mean terms lie. Okay, so let me see one particular problem here. So the first expression I'm going to take, that is f is equal to a bar b bar plus b c bar plus a c. So this particular expression we are going to plot into the K-map. So you can see that there are three variables to be considered. Why? Because a is there, b is there, and c is also there. So you have to have a three variable K-map. So what we are going to do, you first try to write one particular variable over the top position, that is A we have considered here. You can take anything else also, B, C also, can B or C also you can take. We have considered A here. The next thing is B, C, we can write over the left position. Okay. So here, now I want to plot A bar, B bar. How we can write, what is A bar, B bar? That is A is 0, B is also 0. So that means, where you can plot, A is 0, B is 0. So A is 0 means B is 0 means here. So that is where, here. A 1, 1, I am going to plot here. Next thing is, B is, next expression is, B is 1, C bar means it is 0. Okay. So where the value is of A, B is, no? B is, B is 1, B is 1, okay, here, 1, B is 1, and C bar, C bar means it is, here, C bar you have, this is C bar, here also, it's also C bar. So where you can write, that is what is the value? B and T bar. B and T bar. So here, where is B C bar? B C bar. So let us plot that. Here, this is B and B C bar. And next you have A C. A C to be plotted. A C is A is 1, B is 1. A is 1, A is 1, B is also 1. Oh, sorry, C is 1. C is 1. So that is this part. Here you can plot 1. That is A, C. So this is we have plotted function to the K-map. Next thing, well, let's see in the next different problem here. It is giving a different expression. F is equal to A bar C bar plus B bar C plus AB. So this I am going to plot now to the particular in the K-map. So where is A bar C bar? A bar C bar. So this is A bar C bar means A has to take the value 0 and C bar is also 0. So A bar here and C bar is C value is again 0, 0 where you get here. So that's why we are going to plot 1, 1 into this particular thing. Next thing is B bar C. B bar C is B is 0, C is 1. B is 0, C is 1. B is 0, C is 1. Here it is. B is 0. B is this particular thing. B bar C. That is B is 0 and C is 1. Okay, and A and A bar got cancelled. So I have only remaining is B bar C. Next thing is AB. AB you have to plot. So this is already plotted. And AB what to plot? AB where you can plot? A is 1, B is 1. A is 1, A is 1, B is 1. Where this position? That's why we choose this position. So 1, 1. Let us plot in this manner. 1. After plotting, we have to pair it now. Adjacent ones you can pair. So which are adjacent? By looking at this particular thing, you cannot see quad here anywhere. You cannot see in this problem, in both of the problems also. You are seeing, you cannot see any quad. Okay, quad cannot be, quad grouping is not possible. So you have to go for pairs. So this one is adjacent to another one. That's why you pair this manner. Another, this one is adjacent to this one, so that's why you pair in this manner. Again, this one is near, so you have to pair. So again, redundant terms or redundant pairing is removed here. Okay, you can do that, but we will be getting an extra term, so we don't use that redundant. Using consistency theorem, we have already learned. We should not include the redundant term. So that's why it remains in this manner. The next thing is the same kind of mapping is seen in another expression also. So expression is different, but the mapping is similar, is it? So here also, what you have to do, you have to go for pairing. Adding quad is not possible, so we pair. Okay, we try to encircle all the ones. So logically, this one is adjacent to this last one also. So we are going to pair in this manner. So this is how we have to pair the expression.